Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and I'm sure a lot of you guys know, or maybe you guys don't know, but I am currently a graduate student majoring in social work. So I have one more semester to go, actually. It's been finals week for me recently, and I'm pretty much done with school now. So I have one more semester to go, and once I'm done with that semester, I will have graduated with a master's degree in social work with an MSW. And I do plan on taking the license exam to become a licensed master's in social work, so LMSW. So social work is my career aspiration, is my biggest passion, but there are many specialties that you can have in social work field. In NYU, what they're called field learning opportunities, so there are specific tracks, your career track. So I like to make this analogy. Think of surgery, right? You can be a general surgeon, you can be a neurosurgeon, so you can go on a track of specialty of neurosurgery, you can be an orthopedic surgeon, you can be a plastic surgeon, you can be the, what do you call that, like the about bladder and urinary tract, I don't remember the term for that, but there's that surgeon, there's a pediatric surgery. So there are all kinds of surgery major, right? So kind of like that, there are many different areas that you can do social work. There is palliative care. There is school social work. So you're a social worker in high school or in elementary school, things like that. There's psychotherapy, private practice, you know. So there's that. There's mental health. There's hospital social work. So this is called medical social work in some ways. And there is social work in kind of general adult contemporary issues. There's child and family social work and things like that. So there are many areas of social work. At NYU, what my track is called micro/macro social work. So it's kind of an interesting track, really. But it's really looking at combining the ways that the way direct practice or clinical social work is combined with more macro or management social work. That's kind of my track. But in any case, my specialty, my passion really has always been around homelessness. So people who are homeless and also people who are about to be homeless. So areas about affordable housing, and people in poverty generally. So that's been my biggest thing. So in my practice class, my practice 3 class, one of the options that we were given to do as a final project was to make a social media project about a social issue that you care deeply about, that social workers can be involved in. And so that's what prompted me to do this thing. And I have I made this website, although it's less of a website and just like a social media page. I use a social media tool, something like, you know, there's a lot out there now. There's Facebook, which is the most popular, and then there's Twitter. So I was thinking of actually making a Facebook page or group page, but didn't end up happening. It was really complicated for me, but because there was a specific thing I wanted to do. I wanted to really just kind of make it something like an archive where you can go to the page and really learn about what it means to do social work for the homeless population. So there were 4 things I wanted to address, and so you can check out the website. I made it a Pinterest page. I know that's really odd because Pinterest is generally known not for anything, you know, social justice or social issue related or social services related, but it's really where you go to see really cool pictures about arts and crafts and technology and science, and it has all kinds of categories, right? When I did this on the Pinterest site, you know, I mean, it's not going to be surprising that, you know, I edit the board and there's all these categories that pop up. There's no category that is appropriate for what I want to do with the site. I wish there was. I'm actually going to email. I plan on emailing the founders or the president or whoever is in charge of Pinterest. I want to email them and say, hey, look, there are a lot of nonprofit organizations and charity organizations and social services organizations that are now starting to use Pinterest, right? Or have been, actually. So you should really create a category for them. You know, there should be a category for that. It could be social services. It could be social causes, social issues. It could be social justice. It could be nonprofit. Something. It should be... There should be a category for that, because right now there is no appropriate category for any of that. And there are many organizations that use Pinterest. There's the National Coalition for the Homeless. There's a Coalition of Homelessness. There's so many organizations, nonprofit organizations, religious organizations, and churches that use Pinterest now. So it would be nice to have a category that they can kind of slide in there so that more people can access it. And so that's what category does. You know, it allows people to do that. Anyway, I created a website. I created a Pinterest page, really. And it's titled Social Work for the Homeless, parentheses, in the United States of America. Because it really is a biased one in America. The link to my Pinterest page in the description below is still largely a work in progress. There's a lot of things I want to do for this page that has not been done yet, so I'm going to have to spend a lot of time to do it. But it really is the goal of this page is fourfold. You know, the first thing, and they're all trying to answer questions. So first question is, who are the homeless? What types of people are homeless people? Now that's the first question, and that's why I have the section of faces of homelessness. And there's a lot of misconceptions about who the homeless are in America, you know, so a lot of what I need to address for that. And that's probably a topic for a different video altogether. So I'm definitely gonna make a bunch of different videos from this point in the future about different issues about homelessness and whatnot. So I really want to also link my video to the Pinterest page as well. But the second also issue is myths and reality about homelessness. You know, what is homelessness like? Why do people become homeless anyway? You know, that's the second question I want to answer, and that's why the second section is there. The third section is, what can we do about homelessness? You know, and what can social workers do? What are they already doing that I want to highlight? So that's the third section. So that's all really in the context of the United States. It's a very American-centric. And so I wanted to have a fourth section where it's kind of homelessness in other countries. So what can we learn from how homelessness is like in other countries and how other countries address homelessness? What can we learn? What can America learn from that and what's going on? And so those are the kind of four goals of this page. I like Pinterest a lot. There's a lot of limitations to Pinterest, but I really like that it can be like an archive thing. I can invite people to manage the page with me, people I know. I have an option to email them, and they can become part of the pinners, guest pinners, I guess. It's an exciting thing. I doing this project, I actually kind of fell in love with Pinterest in a lot of ways, because it's so easy to be captivated by an image, read like a 500 character blurb, and then be led to a link that has much detailed information and blog. So I definitely need to start making more videos on homelessness and kind of link my blogs to Pinterest. And I also want to do more detailed, in-depth blogs and articles separate from the Pinterest page and link that. So over the winter break, I'm planning on creating this more comprehensive WordPress blog site that links into it. But that's kind of the project that, you know, it was a class assignment. But I think I'm expanding more now to beyond just being for class to get a grade, but really to be more of a resource for people who are interested in learning about homelessness in America and people who are interested in what we can do about it as social workers or just as general people who are interested about preventing and eliminating homelessness in this country. So that's kind of what I wanted to kind of highlight. This is tooting my own work. I know I'm plugging my own work, but I can do that because this is my YouTube channel. But anyway, let me, guys, if you want to know, I'm curious to know what you guys think, any questions that you might have. As usual, you can leave comments and questions in the comment section below. Feel free to email me, of course. My email is always david.etemquan@gmail.com, which is I'm going to put in the video description below. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed, cheers.